All right, guys, this is the full EzAlgo V5 walkthrough. I'm going to be going over everything from getting set up, joining the Discord, optimizing the settings on EzAlgo, and finally becoming profitable. So the first thing we're going to do is get set up, right? If you don't have EzAlgo already, be sure to click the first link in the description below, and that will bring you to our website, www.ezalgo.co. And here you'll find some information about us, what our indicator actually does, some different services that we offer, some results, and then of course the sign up link and to join our Discord. So you can come to this website and scroll around a bit and just check out what we have to offer. Most of these screenshots are for the V4 version, so we do need to update them to the V5, which we'll do pretty shortly. As you can see, we have multiple confirmations, any market, any time frame. You'll see some results, and then you'll see become a member today. What you're going to do to get the EzAlgo indicator is press get access now for pro. That's the only plan that you're going to need. We also have options VIP, crypto VIP, and some other stuff if you guys want some signals. But if you're just starting out and you just want the indicator, you're going to press get access now. And from there, that will bring you to our checkout page, wap.com/easytrades. Again, you're going to click pro. With pro, you get access to the indicator, the premium Discord discussion channels, daily market updates and trade setups, and of course, access to successful traders. You're going to press buy now. And what you're going to do after checkout is press claim roles. There should be an automatic pop-up that connects you with Discord. And once you do that, you're going to be able to join our Discord, discord.gg/easytrades, right? So this is where the EzTrades community is. This is where you can ask questions. If you want to speak to me personally, you can always come over here to support ticket, open a support ticket, tag my username, Matt Pease, and I will get back to you shortly. This is my only Discord account. There are a ton of scammers going around. I'm always going to be the owner, and my tag is always 0001. So keep that in mind. This is my only account. We do not have any EzTrades account. This is my only account. So once you do that, you're going to come over here to username here, and this is where you're going to put your Tradingview username, all right? Not your Discord username, your Tradingview username. And this is how you'll actually be able to get access to the EzAlgo trading indicator and be able to use it on your own chart. So put your Tradingview username here, and then I'll get you added as soon as possible, usually within 8 hours. And just a brief overview on what the Discord looks like once you're in pro. Obviously, we have the information, results, and feedback. We have the mod HQ. You guys won't be able to see that. We have the support tickets. You guys won't be able to see any of that. We have the VIP channels, crypto VIP, and actually shout out to Jay and Air. They're actually live right now. I'm doing some live trading, which is awesome. We have the options VIP, EZFX, which is the Forex, and then the community chats, where we have the general free chat. And also we have questions, crypto, Forex, futures, options, and my favorite, which is the TA setups, where we post daily crypto setups in here. So definitely be sure to take advantage of these channels as well, because these trade setups hit, guys. So if you're taking these, you're definitely doing good. This was a soul trade that I posted the other day. I was looking for a short up here at the top of this parallel channel. It was also an EzAlgo resistance level and a golden pocket. And that was an easy short that we got. And of course, you're communicating with like-minded individuals, which is super important, right? If you want to learn something, learn from the best. Don't just watch YouTube videos and think you're going to figure it all out. You really need that select niche group that do what you want to do so you can learn and follow in their footsteps. And we have some amazing traders in here. Now, if you're unsure on how to use TradingView, what you're going to want to do is go to tradingview.com and create an account if you haven't made one already. Now, I'm assuming most of you already have a TradingView account. So what you're going to want to do is come over here to products, go to chart, and here you'll see whatever asset you're looking at. So whether that's crypto, stocks, Forex, futures, whatever it may be, you'll see the chart right here. And to find out what your username is, you're going to come over here to the top left corner. This is my username, obviously, EzAlgo, and you'll see your username right here. So what you're going to do is just copy that and put it in the Discord if you didn't do that already for the indicator access. And what you're going to do after you do that is come up here to indicators, come down here to invite only scripts. And once you load them in, your chart is going to look something like this. But we're going to change some things and optimize some settings to make it as simple as possible for you to get going and start becoming profitable. So we're going to start with the V5 indicator. So come up here to the top left and you'll see settings. We're going to click on that, and I'm going to break down a little bit what each function does and how you can use it to your advantage. So first things first, we have the buy and sell signals. Now these are pretty self-explanatory, right? These tell you when to buy or sell. However, a majority of our traders, myself included, don't use these signals exclusively, right? We use these in confluence with other EzAlgo signals and of course the support and resistance levels and zones. So we're not gonna blindly follow the buy and sell signals. That's probably the number one mistake I see beginner traders do, is blindly follow these signals. Granted, they are extremely accurate. However, you do want confluence with other EzAlgo inputs, which I'll be getting into shortly. So for the buy and sell signals, we have the sensitivity, which dictates when the buy and sell signals appear. So the standard is 3, right? Don't overcomplicate it. Don't confuse yourself and try to find those exact optimal settings, right? It's pretty much all the same thing. If you want less signals, but more delayed signals, you can turn the sensitivity up to around 5 or 6. Let's try 5. And you'll see that there are gonna be a lot less signals, right? Well, I guess in terms of signals, these were pretty much the same, but they're definitely a little bit more delayed, right? This buy signal didn't close till all the way over here, and this sell signal didn't close till all the way over there. So on a 5-minute time frame, we're probably gonna want a 2 to 3 sensitivity. We're gonna say 3 for now because that is the default sensitivity. And I think that looks pretty good. Like I said, our main trade thesis is gonna be trading the support and resistance levels, not exclusively the buy and sell signal. So always keep that in mind. It also does depend on your strategy. There are a ton of strategies involving the buy and sell signals themselves. But for a majority of you traders out there, especially the beginners, don't worry about the perfect sensitivity yet. Just worry about trading the levels and using these signals as confirmation once you're in the trade. We also have the stop loss. We're gonna set the stop loss to 0, but it does show the entry, stop loss, and take profit if you want to have that. All right, really quick, I just finished making this walkthrough and I realized in the middle of it that there were actually some glitches within EzAlgo. One of them being that we had some inputs missing for the trend dashboard, and another one of them being that the signals offset was not working. So if you're wondering why the trend dashboard changed, it was because I wasn't using the updated version. So if you were added to V5 and haven't updated it yet, be sure to get the updated version. All you're gonna have to do is click out of your EzAlgo V5, come back up to indicators, and load in the EzAlgo V5 indicator once more. All right, back to the video. And another cool feature we've added are the signals offset. All this does is change the distance between the buy and sell label and the candle, right? If I change the signals offset to 1, it's right next to that candle. But if we turn it up to 5, which is the default, it gives it a little bit of breathing room. And also if you have other EzAlgo signals, for example, maybe a reversal signal or an EzAlgo mild sell signal with that red X, it doesn't overlap. We also have the trend ribbon, which shows the overall trend of the market. If I zoom in a little bit, you'll be able to see it a little bit clearer, right? We see the trend ribbon switches from blue to red on this candle right here, which is also a great basis for entry, you know, if you wanted to enter on the trend ribbon flip, which is something that a lot of our traders do, and take profit at the next EzAlgo support level. You can see once again, the trend ribbon flips on this candle right here, breaks past the trend ribbon as it flips from red to blue, take profit at the next resistance zone. And you can do the same thing on the way back, right? Red trend ribbon flip, and a sell signal, we can enter that trade, take profit at the next support zone once again. And you can just do this back and forth, right? As you can see, price breaks through that trend ribbon and flips with a buy signal. That would be our basis for a long entry. Enter on the real price and take profit probably up here at this next resistance level, or maybe even hold it until this next sell signal. So the trend ribbon itself is extremely powerful, and it's a feature of EzAlgo that I don't think enough people use. So don't sleep on the trend ribbon, guys. Super, super powerful indicator. And definitely a great piece of confluence when you're entering your trades. Next, we have the reversal signals, which is also another indicator on EzAlgo that is very underrated, especially at support and resistance levels, right? If I go back a little bit, you'll be able to see we had some of these bearish reversal signals right here, and price eventually dropped. We had this bullish reversal signal, price came back up. Another bullish reversal signal, price came back up. Some more bullish reversal signals, price comes up. And we had a ton of reversal signals right here at the support zone, and price came up. So use the reversal signals in confluence with the EzAlgo support and resistance levels as a basis for entry. We also have the previous day high, low, and close if you guys want these levels as well. And I believe we also have the labels for them. So yeah, we have the previous day close, previous day high, and previous day low. Just adds another level that you could potentially take a trade at. But like I said, definitely not necessary. We also have the EMAs, which haven't changed since the last update. My favorite EMA, if you are wondering, is the 144 EMA. So you can also use these when you're trading as another sense of confluence. We're gonna turn those off for now because they're not necessary. We also have the show swing points, which are a new feature on the V5, and we're going to keep the swing point period 10, don't change that. Essentially shows the swing highs and lows, which can be useful for a couple of things. First thing it can be useful for is setting your stop loss, right? Usually when I say put your stop loss below previous swing low, some people don't know what I mean by that. So for example, if I were to take this sell signal, I'd say, okay, put your stop loss below previous swing high, right? That would be somewhere around here because it says lower high. So we know that that's the previous swing high. So we're going to put our stop loss somewhere around there. You know, target this, take profit. Obviously, these signals are repainting, so they do show after the fact, but it does give you an idea of what trend the market is in, right? If you have higher highs and then lower highs, that tells you that, okay, we could be in a short-term downtrend. So I'll be looking for sells on this time frame, but that's definitely good to have. But for now, we can turn those off. We also have a brand new trend dashboard. I'm gonna actually change the size of this, so we can change it to small, and we can actually change the position of the trend dashboard. So I'm gonna do top right for now, and keep everything else the same. Now, the trend dashboard is based off of the 144 EMA. So on any given time frame, if price is above the 144 EMA, it'll give you a bullish sign. And when price is below the 144 EMA, it will give you a bearish sign. It also tells you the current position and the current trend for whatever time frame you're on. And it also shows you the volume, which can be helpful. But I wouldn't worry about the volume too much, especially if you're a beginner. You don't really need to look at that. Just worry about price action, price structure, and then use this as confluence. If everything's bearish, you probably don't want to be taking any long positions, and vice versa. If everything's bullish, you probably don't want to be taking any short positions. But we're going to keep that on for now because I definitely think it is pretty useful. And last but not least, we have the reversal band. So we're going to keep the length at 30. And the reversal bands are these bands right here. We have the red bearish reversal bands up top and the blue bullish reversal bands at the bottom. So these act as Bollinger bands, but they're actually based on Fibonacci values. So they're similar to Bollinger bands, but also very different. Now, you're not going to be basing your trades off of the reversal bands, obviously. But when price comes to some of these lower reversal bands, you are going to be looking for long positions, right? So use these in confluence with the other EzAlgo signals as well to help you enter or exit a trade. But for now, we can turn these reversal bands off because I'm not really using them. If you like to use Bollinger bands as is, I definitely recommend trying out the reversal bands. If you want to customize EzAlgo a little bit, whether that's colors, whether that's turn some of the inputs off, you can come over here to style. We have the buy label, the sell label. We have the mild buy and the mild sell, which hasn't changed since last update. And a few people have asked what the mild buy and sell are based off of. Well, simply put, the mild buy and sell are the Vu Manchu Cypher B buy and sell dots. So it saves up some screen real estate so you don't have too many indicators on your screen. And we've just coded that into EzAlgo. Now, you don't want to use the mild buy and sell signals on their own, okay? Only use these signals when price is at an EzAlgo support level, like I always preach. We also have the divergence buy and sell, which haven't changed. You can change the bar color, you know, if you choose to do so. I like to keep the blue and red personally. You can also change the opacity. For example, we have these reversal signals over here that load in on a default 30%. We can change that to, let's say, 100% if we want to make them more clear, but I like to keep them on 30% so you can see some other EzAlgo signals as well. We have the EMAs that you can toggle on and off. If you only want to keep one or two EMAs, you can turn some of them off. And of course, the reversal band colors, which you're probably not going to change, and the trend ribbon colors. All right, and now let's move into the EzAlgo SR indicator. So this is the bread and butter of EzAlgo, guys, right? EzAlgo support and resistance levels. We have updated SR to be a monster in this update. These levels are as close as humanly possible to manually drawn zones and as close as you can get within Tradingview limitations to have these accurate of zones, right? And these are brand new inputs in the V5 version, so they're different from V4. And most of you love the support and resistance levels from the last update, so you're gonna love these levels even more, right? They're even more accurate. We have the on and off toggle, the support color, the resistance color, and we also have the SR strength. So the default is going to be 2. If you're just starting out and getting the hang of V5, don't mess around with the strength. Keep it at 2. But what this does is actually dictate how many levels there are. For example, if I turn the strength to 1, we might see some more levels that were hidden, right? So these levels just appeared when I set the SR strength from 2 to 1. However, these levels aren't as strong as the other levels. So we're going to turn this back to 2. Because we want the strongest levels that there are. And if we want even stronger levels, we can turn it up to maybe 3 or 4. And as you can see, that got rid of a support level down here, which wasn't that strong. But for now, we're gonna keep the SR strength at 2. That's default, and that's what I like the best. Something else that we've added with the EzAlgo SR indicator are these zones, right? So we see we have these zones that you can take trades off of. Now, most of the time when I'm referring to support and resistance, I'm usually referring to zones or areas rather than a set level. So the problem with the old support and resistance levels is that it was a straight line, right? A dotted line, which I still have right here. But what we've done is created a zone around that line. So price might not touch that exact price at that level, but if it's in the general vicinity of that zone, right, in that support zone, you're going to be looking for a long position. And you can turn these on and off, obviously. If you're trying to catch a swing failure pattern, you can change the line style to solid, get rid of the zones, and it'll look something like this, right? Which is an option if you want to catch a swing failure pattern. Something else you can do is turn these zones on and off and keep the high and low zones off. So we do have an option to keep the high and low zones off. Now, the reason for this is catching swing failure patterns. So if you're trying to catch a swing failure pattern of this high level, you're not going to want a zone. You're going to want a straight line, wait for price to come up to that level, and then look for a swing failure pattern at that high level. So you don't need zones for that, which is why we made an option to specifically toggle on and off the high and low zone. So this can be very, very useful. And something else you'll notice about the new V5 support and resistance levels is that we added the high and low candlestick wick. So in the previous updates, we didn't have levels here for these high candlestick wicks. And a lot of the time when you're catching swing failure patterns, you're catching them off of a high or low candlestick wick, which is why we added the inputs to load in levels at these high and low candlestick wicks, which is, in my opinion, a game changer and definitely one of my favorite features of the SR. But for now, we're going to turn all the zones on. And we can also change the width of the zone. If we want to make this a little bit wider, we can turn it up to maybe 5%. Honestly, I'm not a fan of these super, super wide zones. That kind of defeats the whole point. So keep the zone width at 2%. And we also have an expand SR function, which is automatically toggled on. But if you uncheck that, you'll notice that it gets rid of the support and resistance levels at a certain length back. And the reason for this is that some people don't want these big lines going through their entire chart. So it only appears during recent price action. I think it's within the last 300 candle bars, it will show these levels, right? And you can see V5 is just killing it in some of these higher time frames. If I expand SR, if I turn that on, you'll be able to see these zones are literally more accurate than my own manually drawn zone. So I don't even do my own TA anymore. If you're in the Discord and you see some of my setups, I don't even draw anything anymore. I just throw on EzAlgo and play these levels. That's how accurate they are. If you wanted to turn off these labels, you can come in here to style, turn off labels, or you can even turn off the lines and just keep these zones, right? Which is also something that you could do. But personally, I like to have these on. It just helps me visualize the market a bit better. And now we're gonna go into alerts. So if you come up here to the top right corner, press create alert, you're gonna press EzAlgo V5 as the condition, and you'll be able to set alerts on the trend ribbon cross, right? The blue trend ribbon alert, buy signal, divergence buy signal, either a buy or sell signal, mild buy signal, red trend ribbon alert, reversal signal, sell signal, and then just a trend ribbon color change in general. So you don't have to be sitting in front of your computer screen all day. You can set alerts for these signals. For example, we'll do buy signal. We're gonna do once per bar close, have your message right here, and you can have it notify you via pop-up, email, app. In terms of strategies that you can use with EzAlgo, we're currently working on 20 plus proven and back-tested strategies that you can use with EzAlgo inside of the Pro Discord. So if you want those strategies, be sure to click the first link in the description below. Get yourself EzAlgo, get in the Pro Discord, and in the strategies forum, we'll be posting all of those strategies within the next coming weeks with how to use the strategies and the exact EzAlgo settings that you're going to need. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this walkthrough. I hope it was thorough enough and you understand how to get set up and start using EzAlgo to profit. As with any trading strategy, make sure you keep in mind your support and resistance levels and zones. So whatever strategy you're using, make sure to not just blindly follow the signals and keep price action in mind, which EzAlgo does a great job of helping you out with these automatic support and resistance zones. If you enjoyed this walkthrough, be sure to leave a like, subscribe to the channel for more trading content, and I'll see you guys next video.